What's up, Food Podcast, live podcast with Felipe Esparza.
And Rodrigo Torres.
And Flaco over here, man.
What's up, everyone?
Over there, away from the camera. Nobody can see him, man.
Just a sliver just over there.
If you want to call in a half hour to 323-282-7424. The question of the day is, do you feel safer in America?
Do you feel safer in America?
Since the day I was born, dog.
Yes. Have you ever felt afraid to walk down the street?
We live in Baghdad, dog. It's the safest
No, bro. We live in Highland Park.
The guy with the red hat or what?
People love right away yelling out their city. Huh? Like, shout out to Boyle Heights. Enough of the shout outs.
Oh, dude. People swear they're the representatives, huh, fool? And people always have you shout shit out for them too, huh? Yeah. Come on, dog. Tell them Odessa's in the house. Big dog.
Odessa doesn't need to be in the house. Odessa needs to stay in Odessa.
The city of Bell.
Shout out to Waco, bro.
Waco. Oh, the birthplace of Steve Martin.
So we got to do this real quick, man.
Go for it, dog.
Upcoming shows. Next week, March 11, I'll be in Tampa, Florida as a guest on the Mike Epps Show at USF. Sun Dome. You might get some cigar. You never know.
Yeah, Ybor City.
Yeah, we go to Corona, right? Uh-huh. To get those coffees.
Fuck yeah. Forget about it, dude.
Oh, man.
Bomb is espresso ever, but not as bomb as La Carreta.
No. But you could sit there even if you don't have a cigar, huh?
Oh, yeah. Just chill, dude. Get all amped
up. Just talk to old people there.
Oh, right there. Me me gusta mi steak asina.
Shout out to La Corona Cigar Shop in Ybor City, Florida. Also to the other place that I hung out with when you weren't there with Adam Murray, I met a guy they call El Chapo.
Where they were rolling the cigars?
Yeah, they were rolling the cigars. Called how do you say that Egyptian name for a woman?
The Egyptian name for a woman.
La Forma. I don't know. We'll get back to it. La Faroa, the Pharaoh.
The Pharaoh.
Yes, the Pharaoh right? Cigar Shop. It's called La Faroa. La Faroa with the lady called La Faroa. There was a guy singing outside in Spanish. She was rolling up cigars.
Aquí mi tierra.
This biker showed up, bro. I don't know. There was cigar clubs that are bikers. Cigar biker club.
Like an enthusiast.
They're all, yeah.
No, yeah, but they were called apuros.
Aficionados.
Aficionados.
There you go.
I just repeat whatever he said. That's a big word, Flaco.
Aficionados. Yeah.
Flaco over here, man, taking notes here of the meeting.
What are you doing, outlining, dog?
We have a podcast secretary over here.
Yeah, he's brainstorming, eh?
That fool writes here freehand.
Your everyone other hand is a clerk, eh?
What yeah, man.
Like a stenographer, dog.
There you go.
Dude, we hung out with a healthy version of you, bro.
Did you see I saw the tweet, bro. I was dying, dude. I was messed up.
We're calling him Healthy Flaco.
Who was that? Who tweeted that?
I did.
No, life from San Antonio.
In San Antonio, it was some fool. I already forgot his name.
Some fool that follows us. Fucking
some fool we gave all the stress joints to. Let me tell you, man, when somebody hooks you up with a lot of weed or takes it to the bag, I'm going to smoke you out, it's always bad weed, huh?
Yeah, it is, right? You kind of feel, I thought you liked me, man. Like,
no, only 2 out of 10 times you get good weed, dog.
Yeah, man. That especially when they give you the whole bag, he'll roll yourself whatever you want.
Yeah, you can take what you want. I'm like, all right, just leave the whole thing.
Ain't nobody leaving no Louis XIII alone,
oh,
huh?
Hell nah. That shit's guarded. That shit's in a safe.
Nobody has ever left you good weed and a clean bong.
Nah.
It's always bad weed and a dirty-ass bong with oil in it.
With a crack.
Also, shout out to that tattoo place. I already forgot the name of it.
Sutulu.
Yes, yeah, Sutulu tattoo shop in
San Antonio, Texas.
San Antonio.
Downtown.
And
used to be a
skate shop and clothing, but they just went to the tattoos.
A couple of knickknacks.
You got work there, Lisa? Or have you got work there?
Oh.
Oh, my bad. You're not on the. Never mind.
Flaco right here, man.
What's going on?
I'm breaking the fourth wall. Sorry.
Behind the scenes over here, fool.
If Flaco in a movie, he'll start a conversation with a sound guy. Hey, man, can you hear me?
What's I want up, everybody babe? To be involved.
Let's have
man.
Lunch,
think about another take, bro.
Okay.
So, next week, getting back to next week, March 16th through the 18th, Spokane, Washington, at the Spokane Comedy Club. March 23rd through the 25th. El Paso, I'm coming back to you, you dirty town. I'm going back to hang out over there at I always say Chico's Tacos, but I never go there, bro.
No? Man,
we went there to hang out that one night, though.
No, that people, huh? Remember we hung out with a Chico's Tacos son? Yeah. Unless he was lying, dog.
I think he was lying, fool. One fool we gave him that cheap-ass weed, too, fool.
Yeah, man. He was like a healthy Kiko, bro.
A Kiko? Who's Kiko?
I'm a Chavo del Ocho.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Gordito, dog.
A comedian.
He just started hanging out with, hey, man, I'm a big fan. My dad owns the Chico's Tacos. Bro, we a limo at, dog?
He's a mogul.
He wanted to hang out long, man. I don't know how we got rid of him, buddy. He was gone. Also, March 31st, Detroit, Michigan, as a guest on the Mike Epps Show. Okay. August. April 1st, Baltimore, Maryland, as a guest on the Mike Epps Show. Check out the philippeworld.com/tour for all the info. Shout out to everyone who reviewed us on iTunes. Also, man, keep bringing those reviews on iTunes, okay? We need them. We're falling off the number 200. We're back to 300.
Damn.
So we're going to need you guys to write a review this week and tell us what you found about Flacco coming back to the show. Also, Flacco has a show coming up, man, but actually it's more like an eFundMe.
Okay, Kickstarter.
And the Kickstarter worked, right? So,
where is this show at, bro?
I have a show in San Jose at the San Jose Improv and one at the Ontario Improv. March 15th on San Jose Improv, and you get tickets on the website. And then Ontario Improv is going to be March 28th.
You're headlining?
I'm headlining.
Orale. Whose show is it? Your show?
One of them, I got co-producing, I guess, with Luz Bastos, and the other one with Brian McDaniel. All
right. Yeah. And who else on the show? Anybody from up north?
Birdman.
Birdman, bro. Birdman's going to be on the show with me.
You tell that fool to be clean, bro. 5 minutes. Get the hell off the stage.
Nah, we love Birdman, man. Remember the cars? With his, was it his cousin?
Oh, yeah, the limos.
There Maserati was a Ferrari.
Who would let that guy a car, man?
Dude.
And then give it to me.
I loved it, man. We went to Taco Bell in, like, a Ferrari and, like, ordered $2 meals. It was,
that's
like,
true, dog.
Also, $5 gas.
Also, you use that. You use a Maserati at the Raider game as a sleeping bag.
Oh, that's right. Hey, man, I was tired.
You passed out, bro. You drank too much tequila, dog, too early. Shout out to everyone who reviewed our show. Who are these fools?
C. Caesar, Willow Dog 86, Jason Bourne in Mexico, who listens to the old shows again when he runs out of new episodes. Record 1979, GFY Boy 951 from Moreno Valley, turned his wife onto the podcast. Manuel from East LA, Susie Carrillo, Steve G from the Inland Empire, and Weather Gazer, who used to think I was just a character Gabriel Iglesias made up, but now he's a big fan of the podcast.
Real, bro.
Yeah, dog.
Sound like Arlo Bo right now, bro.
Also, yeah, man. Oh, today's Ash Wednesday, man. What's your Ash, Flacco? Right.
I'm not Catholic, dude.
Oh, you never knew
what?
Catholic?
No.
You
get out of here.
You're going to hell.
It's the only day a priest touch you, and it's cool.
That's, I mean, when you're Christian, who touches you? It's not a priest.
Does it dip you in water?
I guess a family member? I don't know.
He puts your deacon on you.
Open up,
priest,
dog.
To me, bro. Who's in the molesting business in the Christian religion?
It has to be a creepy uncle or something. Or like, yeah. Like,
probably a Bible study. Man, there used to be this, man, the way you're dressed right now reminds me of the guy.
Victory Outreach.
No, bro. When I was a kid, there used to be this big old white fool, bro. He just showed up to the neighborhood, right? He had big ass fucking first baseman hands.
Big old NFL
hands. First baseman glove hands, bro. Big old hands, right? His name was just Rod.
Rod.
And he dressed like you.
Manotas, eh?
And exactly, bro. And that for you to go around talking to all the sad sack kids around the neighborhood, right? About Christianity and then he'll take them all to go eat. Bro.
It's dusky, though.
Somehow, I just remember right now, my mom never let me go alone with that motherfucker.
Yeah, fuck that.
I just thought about that right now. Because the first time I went there, I went with my friend Richie, R.I.P. Richie Sniper, you know where you are, Aliso Village. That fool, man, he went with me, right? And then Rod, he bought me a Bible. And then we would pray. Then he took us to go eat. And then he took me to his job at the train tracks in San Fernando. Because he lived there. He used to be the guy that switches the tracks.
A conductor of some sort?
A conductor, right?
I was getting creepy.
An engineer, right? And then I wondered, I could never win alone. Then another time I took my gay brother, Fernando, but I didn't know he was gay then. And the whole time, bro, when we were praying, we're about to like close your eyes and pray, that fool was flipping them off, dog.
He knew what was up.
I was dying, bro. You're making me laugh. I was trying to take you serious, fool.
Ah, Brothers don't take you serious.
But man, I never took that fool. I never took my brother again to tag along anywhere, bro. He never took shit serious, dog.
I'm so concentrated.
It was funny, dog, because we were about to have our hands closed and pray with a big ass fool.
Focus.
And focus and nothing, man. I think later on, man, a friend of mine named Carlos Vasquez or Tovar said that fool was like a molester, bro. But I don't know. He never touched me. He was huge.
Damn, that's kind of. How old were you guys, dude?
12, 13.
Fuck, dude, go ride a bike and enjoy shit fucking over there praying, dog.
Yeah, man, but you know, man, everybody took us to McDonald's, bro.
Oh, yeah, that's can't fuck with McDonald's when 12 years old.
Had a quarter pounder with cheese, bro. Ooh. Strawberry shake and fries.
Give me one now, dog.
You want anything else?
You're going to take the chance.
A little tap on the shoulder. You want anything else?
Oh, who does that, dog?
So who touched you, bro?
No one touched me. They're
you look cute, bro. Like, you look like dude, you're small and skinny, bro. You're like a... You're a rabbit, bro. You're a prey, dog.
I'm a prey. Nobody wanted to touch me. I don't know.
You lied.
Don't lie, dog. Who fucked up those glasses when you were little?
Nah, man. That's one thing I never.
We got that fucking haircut, bro. Like the guy that the fucking editor of the fucking newspaper that Spider-Man works at, bro.
J.K. Simmons.
Frankie Valli in the Four Seasons haircut. Eh?
Oh, this guy.
If, I was gonna ask.
No, what's the name of the guy from Superman? From Spider-Man, his boss.
Fucking Lex Luthor.
No.
I don't even know, dude.
No, I. Yeah.
Of course I know. J. Jonah. Jameson.
J.J. Jameson haircut, bro.
J.J. Jameson.
Yeah, bro, the guy was drunk on Jameson, bro. Shout out to our engineer, Aaron.
Yeah.
Hooking it up all the time with the facts.
We're breaking the fourth wall here all day, baby.
Hey, quick question. How long you guys been Christian for? Your grandma Christian too? Or she?
Yeah, that's what we were like, always raised really? At. Like, yeah, like, I just assumed everybody was
Catholic
Christian.
Converters? There's a lot of, like,
no,
Catholic,
I've no? never.
Hallelujah over here.
The first time for real, yeah, like.
Don't they jump up and down and pray with tambourines and shit?
And cry after?
Dude, it's a party in there.
And hold snakes? My mom used to bag on people like that. That's what used to know they were the pinches hallelujahs.
That's what we were, yeah.
They always have something bad to say about Catholics, huh?
I don't know what they say about us. They say in our face. But we used to make fun of all the other religions, bro. Like, we'll pass by.
The door knockers?
We used to pass by because sometimes we'll be passing by the church, and like the Catholic church that we went to with the Lord's Mission, you know, we have Father Greg Boyle here. It was usually in the afternoon, like 3 o'clock, the Vietnamese would take over the church, bro.
Damn.
And a bunch of Vietnamese, dog, that food that we had on the show,
Malani
and his family, Leilani. Bro. And they were all dressed up like KKK, dog.
Oh,
no,
right.
No, not KKK, but they had like white gowns and that's white like hats.
All traditional,
but yeah. They were preaching Catholicism. But I didn't know, bro. They were just, you know, we didn't wear outfits, bro. Yeah, man. So
they went dressed up like for the occasion.
Yeah. It's like they were wearing the same clothes when they were indoctrinated
to the religion. Cause what are they over there? What are Vietnamese originally like? Buddhists or something?
I don't know, man. Communists.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
That's crazy, man.
So what's going on in your world, bro? What happened to your family, bro? You guys are breaking up?
No, we're good.
How's the dog?
I'm not.
The badass white dog.
Oh, the dog's gone.
How's the dog?
Oh, it sucks. Gone. Yeah. Flaco had a dog. That was exactly the same dog from Lost Boys, the white one.
Oh, the white one, yeah. That's what you used to call him, right?
You know, with fucking vampires.
Dude, we had to give him up, and we gave him to his family, and they cut his nuts.
They could barely feed you, dog, yeah. Let alone the dog.
They cut his nuts, but were they Buddhists?
No.
No, they took the family Jews?
No, but they cut his nuts. I never heard about this, but
he had little babies, right?
He became violent. Like, instead of becoming, like, calmer, yeah, like, he got, like...
Because he was old. He was too old to get his balls cut. That's
maybe,
why.
Maybe, right?
Wouldn't you be pissed if they cut your balls off right now? You'd be raging, fool. You start eating and shit.
You mean
he got neutered? Yeah. Oh, he got neutered,
oh. Yeah. All old, yeah, sorry. I should have...
I always thought it was a dog.
He's pissed off, like, yeah.
I'll be pissed,
So then what happened?
He bit somebody. He bit somebody and, like...
They put him to sleep?
I think they're going to.
Oh, I saw.
Oh, he bit somebody just recently?
Yeah, well, it was a few months ago, so I'm pretty sure. I mean, it's not my dog anymore, so...
He got moved through the dog couldn't stay?
Yeah, we had a place that didn't allow dogs, so we had to give him up. It was like...
I would have just moved to another place, man. You know, my dad, we were moving now, looking for a place to live in Boyle Heights. and we had like 4 or 5 kids. And then the lady looked, we were looking for an apartment, she looked at us and said, well, you guys have like 4 kids, you know, we only allow like, this is a two bedroom, you know, you could only have like 2 kids. Then my dad looked at us and looked at that lady and goes, I'll be back, I'm gonna kill the other, I'm gonna kill the other 3 right now in the back. Everybody thought that fool gonna kill us, dog.
Should call Rod.
Started choking my brother. I'll help you, Dad.
I'll help you, Dad.
This fool, dog. Bunk bed city,
dog. Oh, shit.
Killing yeah, man, when I was a kid, it used to always be like some type of Christian showing up, bro, like trying to convert people. Dude. Like at my cousin always. Wendy's house in Santa Paula, there used to be a bus that will show up every Wednesday at 6 p.m. right after dinner and pick everyone up and take them to church. It was called the Joy Bus.
The Joy Bus full of cholos, huh?
There wasn't many cholos back then, bro. It was just a bunch of kids, bro. I went there because, you know, man, there was always snacks.
Oh, hell yeah.
There was always punch or cookies or something, bro.
It was the 7-day advantage.
I was a little whore for that shit, dog. Oh, and somebody told me they're going to go with Doritos and Springfield Colas. Yeah, I'm there, man.
This was at Springfield Colas.
They're going to buy no Cokes, bro.
Shasta's the best you can do.
Shasta was good.
Fuck yeah.
Diet Cola? Shasta.
Oh, man. Mr. Pepper. Or was it Mr.? Is it Mr. Pepper?
Mr. No. Pibb.
Mr. Pibb.
Yeah. You rinse with root beer how we brush your teeth?
I smoke a lot, bro. Yeah, I got to go to the dentist. But yeah, I smoke all day. Dude.
Lisa just went to the dentist, bro. They might take all her teeth off, the bottom ones.
One, 2. Jesus Christ.
I was trying to add drama to the show. I was trying to, you know, link up that drama to the inch of the castle.
No one's going
to
care about one,
go
two.
Back to see what happened to that tooth.
Oh, my God, dude.
All right, people. See you guys later.
Yeah, man.
See you guys.
Oh, man.
What's up, folks?
Yesterday, it's Ash Wednesday, so we talked about Ash Wednesday. Mm-hmm. And, man, when you were a kid, dude, did every gang banger you knew had an Ash on it?
No, I grew up around Christians.
Okay, man.
But you grew up in East L.A., fool.
Well, like City Terrace, but they're...
Okay, man.
East L.A. light.
Like,
you
know,
did you see those people and your mom say, look at everybody with the mark of the beast?
I really didn't see that until like I was in junior high, to tell you the truth.
You didn't have glasses till then, eh?
It's weird.
Shut the hell up.
when we were in a housing project, we used to go get the Ash Wednesday from Father Greg Boyle, and then not even an hour later, man, we're slagging dope with ash on our fucking foreheads, bro.
You can arrest me today. The power of Christ compels, dog.
Yeah, man. Sometimes people didn't have ash, I had to give them a headbutt.
Just a share your ash.
That'll suck, dog. That's how I got my ashes, dog.
One time some girl's ashes disappeared when she went down on me. All right.
Oh, shit.
And her ashes looked like they were brushed off. Like bad mascara. Hey, how come they call it mascara? It's a mascara. A lot of people, I remember, man, I did a comedy show and people showed up with an Ash Wednesday, bro.
I know, at the Wild Coyote, every year, dude.
They're all fucked up, man.
Yeah, fool. It's like, dude, you can. I would get it, but I would just wash it off.
So wait, this is the last day you get to do stuff, or is it yesterday?
No, today, Wednesday, is supposed to be the beginning of Lent.
Okay, so today is the last?
You gave up something, bro.
Today you gave it up, then.
Not everybody.
Yeah, once you go over there and get that little thumb to the forehead.
Yeah, my dad will give up drinking through all of Lent, and then...
Quaresma.
And then... Like typical, you know, of Catholics. Shout out to Glenn Carlin. On the last day of Lent, my dad will get fucked up, bro.
Gotta bring it back strong, dog.
You get fucked up, fucking hiding the Easter eggs all over the place.
Twisting his ankle.
We used to go Easter egg hunting, bro. You didn't do that, huh?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, we did that. That's a Christian thing too, I think. I mean, well, I don't know where it originated from, but
it's pagan.
Pagan.
We stole it, right? Yeah.
I know Maximiliano's wife brought it to Mexico, Carlota.
Did you guys go Easter egg hunting with your family?
Yeah, every year, dog. Love that shit.
I hated that our eggs were real, bro.
Hey, don't break it. Bring it over here.
Bring it back. Yeah, we need them tomorrow.
No, they were hard boiled, right? But
I'd eat them, dog.
There was no money. Like, you know, they put money in them. Who, dog?
I don't know who was throwing out dollars, but I got real eggs. I just ate them after with salt.
Yeah, we used to go look for other people's eggs. We were egg exhausted. All right, people.
That's a funny story. You busted out that joke at the Laugh Factory, and something like the crowd went boo or something after you, like, you kept going with the tag, and then, all right, give it up for my, oh, no, you know, I'll give it up for my writer over there, Ivan Cuellar, and the audience looked at him and was all, boo. At the original Latino night.
Fool, I'm embarrassed.
That's funny, dude.
That was a story he always used to tell, dog. A boomer used to do this.
That's what he used to say. He used to have a joke that would, like, to explain himself all the time. I forgot how it goes. Anyways, move on. Shout out to everybody that works on Superstore. Oh, and we have a lot of the Superstore crew, bro. The light man, the sound guy, some of the DPs. Not deep penetration, bro. Director of photography. They watch the show. This guy right here, Hassan
Wahid.
Shout out to Hassan Wahid. He's one of the camera operators of the show.
Hell yeah, and dude.
I saw him yesterday at the Superstore rap party.
How long does the filming take? Or how long do you there when you film?
Bro, I got 5 lines, bro, and I leave, bro.
Yeah, just in and
I
out.
Just do my job, bro. Oh,
there you go.
I learned everything from Fred Stoller's book.
Oh, there you go.
I'm not Fred Stoller at the fucking set, bro. I don't care if it'll bring me back. Eh?
The do's and don'ts.
My job is to, like Fred Stoller says, your job. This makes a lot of sense. When I was at the Superstore rap party, they had a gag reel where they show all the bloopers of the season, of all the cast, and Fred Stoller was right. They didn't show no guest stars blooping. Or no special guest star blooping, because when you're a guest star on a show, there ain't no time for a fucking blooper on your ass.
You can't
just
point.
Laugh. Let's try it again. Hell no, bro. You're gonna get it right.
That shit.
They're gonna call somebody out. They're gonna replace you with fucking Willie Barcena or Jeff Garcia or Gabriel Iglesias.
Probably.
Yeah, man. So shout out to the gag reel. Everybody was there for. I ran into Ruben Fleischer, one of the executive producers of the show, Justin. And man, it felt good walking in there, bro, and people knowing who you were. I was kind of embarrassed to go because, hey, man, I'm not a primetime player. Only been on 3 episodes.
You're part of the show, though, dog.
But when I showed up, bro, man, the first person they called me over was American Ferreira.
Tight.
And I was like, what? And she was telling Lisa, oh, he was funny, man. I was going, when we were going over the editing, I was like, who is this guy?
It's me, Doc.
I'm the guy, man.
Tight, dude.
And then I ran into Ruben Fleischer, and then the other producer of the show, and then I ran into Hassan. And it's funny, man, I did everything you got to do at a party like this before you leave. Meet, say hi to the main people. And the rest is just having fun. I was going to do some karaoke, man, but I don't want to have a nickname, you know, like, I fuck up.
And then I'll be like karaoke like, guy, yeah.
I don't want to be
like
karaoke guy.
Give it up for David Lee Roth.
But a lot of people busted out some Mike Fierro karaoke stunts, bro.
Like, really, like getting...
Like some fool got on the floor and started singing that song from Queen. I'll be the producer of the show listening.
Bohemian Rhapsody,
bro.
Damn.
Easy, bro. Let it go. Won't you let me go? Beatles. He was on the floor, bro. And when he got off the stage, I said, good job, man. Oh, you like that? Yeah, man. That's my song.
I needed it with Wayne and Garth. Eh?
Yeah, man. So that was that, bro.
Tight, dude.
So no karaoke.
So we were in San Antonio last week, bro. I was pissing off the tourists during the tour. I like to pass by the tourists, you know, the Midwestern people.
Yeah.
Getting to know what happened at the Alamo. I always like to yell out, tell them who won, dog.
Tell them who won.
Tell them who kicked ass at the Alamo. Tell them how Custer or somebody shit in their pants.
How Davy Crockett was shit.
What's up with that fucking Alamo cop, bro?
dog.
Right. We saw an Alamo cop in the middle of the night.
Oh, you're talking
and
about.
We had to ask him, bro. Where in the hell did Ozzy Osbourne pee?
We thought he pissed on the Alamo.
Actually, he peed at the memorial of all the names. Shout out to Captain Gregorio Esparza. He peed at the memorial of Sam Bowie, Custard, and all the other people. So he was peeing there.
Not actually on the Alamo.
Not the Alamo.
No, no, no.
What would have happened if he would have peed there, sir?
Well, what would have happened? He would have got beaten half to death. That's what would have happened in Ozzy.
That's what they said?
Shut the fuck up. Oh,
looking at that fuck on, dude. Don't make me laugh right now, dog.
Yeah, so.
Brisket breath.
So, and then Alamo Juan told us that Ozzy Osbourne was wearing a dress when he peed at the Alamo. And we asked him, how come we're wearing a dress? Because Sharon Osbourne didn't want Ozzy to come outside and party. So she fucking hid all his clothes. He had no clothes.
So that's what
he put on her dress, took off in a limo, got fucked up, and had it to pee. And I asked the Alamo guy, did he squat or lift his dress? He goes, I don't know.
That's a good piss, man.
I got arrested for pissing in public.
Right, in Arizona, huh?
You got arrested, indeed. Bro?
For peeing in public? That's for
peeing
in public.
You told him your finger, bro.
I was there telling him it's not a big deal, but.
That's a good one, dog. Are you doing that right now? So explain to me what happened
March
exactly.
15th. I was, I left
you
the
hanging
club.
Out with Dylan, how the fucking kiss of death.
Actually, yeah, he was there that night.
See?
Bro, bad luck, bro. When somebody has bad luck like that, it's going to catch on, bro.
Spread,
I was the kiss of death, bro. Oh, anybody shit. I was in the car with got arrested.
It's like, oh, all right.
When you got bad luck for a while, it's going to carry on, bro. You need an Olympia or something, dog.
It's like that movie, It Follows. Like
it does follow, bro.
All right.
So what happened, bro?
Well, yeah, we left the club.
I was close to the mic. It don't bite.
We left the club. I was drunk, and I had to take a piss. There was nothing around but a tree. And it was like right in the, you know how like, remember church?
Yeah.
Remember how that street was? Imagine if I took a piss there, like on Harbor Boulevard and like, what was it, Fullerton? Like, you know, like right in the middle of where cops would be, and like, I was that fucked up. And
oh, you were in a divider in a little island.
Yeah, like just right in the middle.
Oh man, you were a little hooker, huh?
Look at freak show over here.
And then next thing I know, I saw like four cops around me, and then
took
like,
four cops to get you.
I mean, I wasn't running away. Like they just surrounded me, and I was
like, society.
"What is Casey Kasem doing alive?"
No, but they were telling me like, "You can't piss here," and I was like, "All right, cool, give me the ticket." And they're like, "No, you're going to jail." And I'm like, that's,
"For drug in public?
For indecent exposure, I guess."
Whoa.
You're lucky, man. You know, nowadays
that's what they told me.
They could get you for
sexual
predator.
That's what they told me that, and it was like by a college too. So like they said that I was like
fucking rapist.
No, and then also too, when I was in the court, like I was handcuffed, whatever, and like the handcuffs were falling off my hands. Like that's not a joke. Like that shit. But the person next to me told me to put them back on because they could get you for trying to escape.
They're trying to set you up, bro.
Yeah, like that's what I hear too. That they'll leave them kind of loose just to like yeah, and then get you for more time.
What if you're Houdini?
If you're Houdini, right?
Well, you hear what was your charge?
Houdini.
Indecent proposal.
What is a proposal?
Don't be proposing to cops, dog.
Hey, cop. Like, hey, I'll marry you if you let me go, bro.
Let me do you a quick 5-minute set.
Indecent exposure.
It was Arizona. I didn't want to go to jail.
Wow. I remember I was caught having sex in a car, man. Elysian Park. And the cops showed up.
What did you do? You didn't.
Fool, they asked me, not her. They asked me, how old are you? Because I look young.
Okay, that's cool. That's better than the old.
And I said, I'm 20-something. And I was 20-something.
They let you guys go? They didn't arrest you guys or nothing?
Hell no, man.
Oh, why? Dude, that's awesome.
What'd you get?
I just said that we were looking for something.
Okay.
There was a prize in there, officer.
No, yeah.
They didn't get it for nothing, bro. I was scared, you know?
Oh, that's cool, dude.
But I just remember right now. But yeah, man. But they could have charged you for what?
Sexual.
And you have to go door to door. Hey, man, I like peeing in public.
Yeah, basically.
But that sucks because if you get arrested for that, those people in jail don't know it's for peeing. Because when they think sexual predator, they think you molested a kid.
Yeah.
They should clarify that.
Yeah.
People don't pay attention, bro.
Well, not the smartest apples in there.
Yeah, they put what your crime is, but people don't read that. They just
let me see your paperwork, dog.
But yeah, man.
And let them put sick as a dog. They don't write that. You just had diarrhea.
Yep.
They don't care.
Sexual predator, huh?
No. Indecent proposal. Indecent exposure. Well, sorry, I've just been watching movies all day.
You want to bribe the guy now.
Indecent exposure. I say that word.
Snake charmer over here.
Hey, when you try to bribe a cop in Mexico, if you initiate it, you have to wait for the cop to initiate it, not you, huh?
In Mexico,
I thought they would love it if you initiated first.
In Mexico, like, I think it's like it doesn't really matter either or. No.
Like if you hand over your wallet, like in that guy from Fargo, we could take care of here than Culiacan.
You
hand over your wallet with a 50 in there, he probably think you have more, huh?
Well, yeah, it's a mordida, dude, and they'll be all like, no, I need more. What the
fuck? Do all the cops put all the money together and then share it or what?
Like a tip jar?
I think some do have a network, and then I know some of them don't.
No way.
I know there was one in Acapulco that used to jack people all the time, Federal de Caminos, and they found him on the side of the road with fucking dollar bills inside of his nose. And gutted, yeah.
Like the end
Why,
of
he wasn't sharing?
I guess he was just by himself, but he was doing it for days, dude, and finally somebody got tired of that shit.
Wow.
All the trucks that get stopped, dude, they fucking know that every cop that stops them is like, what's up? Me debes un billete de 500, güey.
So what's up with La La Land, bro?
I don't know.
To get off the hell off the stage.
You got Warren Beatty right here.
I was listening to Howard Stern, and he was talking about how horrible it would have been if Moonlight was up there and actually La La Land won.
That's
it would have been reverse, huh? That makes sense, though.
It would have been happening, bro. Racist!
Yeah, people would still be talking about it.
Yeah, so Howard Stern was talking about that. What do you guys think?
How the fuck could you mess up a car? What's up with your prescription?
Man, they were blaming it on poor Warren Beatty, bro.
Faye Dunaway, right? What's her old ass doing, dog?
She's been done away a long time ago.
Well, she's the one that said.
Did you see the way he snatched the envelope off his hand?
Oh,
I forgot a paper cut.
Dude, what the fuck? How do you fuck that up, dude?
I think they just left the other card in there, right?
Well, Emma Stone said she had it on her hand.
Oh, wow.
They have one on each side. Who handed it to him?
So in the end, whose mistake was it?
PricewaterhouseCoopers.
That's his name?
No, the accounting firm who's always handled the results. They keep them in a suitcase and everything. But one guy on each corner of the stage has the same card. Emma had hers. The other guy had Emma's.
Damn. Baba boy.
And then the other guy came out and gave it to
him. Imagine that would happen in Last Comic Standing.
Oh, my God.
A lot of people, you know, it's time to get rid of these old farts, bro, in charge of that shit.
Old farts.
And bring in some young people.
Yeah,
we need
dude.
Young blood.
Time for new blood, dude.
Bring in some 20-year-old, dog. Right, Flaco?
And they'll really fuck it up.
So what, Flaco, where do your hand begin, dog?
Where does my hand begin?
Yeah.
What do you mean by that?
All right. What's up, fool? Everybody see your hand.
Oh, my bad. Well, that's for you.
Right.
On camera.
I love you and Christmas Story. No,
Simon
the
Burge.
Nightmare Before Christmas.
The Nightmare Before Christmas.
So your show is every what day?
The Ontario Improv is going to be once a month, the last Tuesday of the month.
Yeah, but what exact date?
Oh, the date, March 28th.
That's a kickoff show?
Kickoff show, 8 p.m. And then also Ontario Improv. I mean, sorry, San Jose Improv, March 15th.
All right, we got to get you back to let her know who bombed in that show. Our listeners love hearing who bombed. Some of our listeners, they treat the podcast like a hen house, bro. Like, whatever we say, they go cry and go tell the person. Fucking metiches, bro.
Oh, my God.
All right, bro. Say hello.
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 Who's this?
Hang on.
Hello.
Yellow.
What's up? Who is
What's
this?
Up, fool?
Gorilla.
What up, man?
Who's this? Where are you from?
It's Raul from Albuquerque, man.
Oh, yeah. What's up?
What's up?
Live from Burke.
I'm from Burke. Green salsa for everybody.
All right, man. Raul.
Yeah.
What's up, Raul? You feel
and
safer?
Green tacos, too, if you want.
What's up, fool? The question right now is, tell him, Flaco.
Do you feel safer now, Raul?
Do you feel safer now in America than you did 4 years ago? Or you don't see the difference, eh?
Man, we're in fear, man. We can't even go to Mexico and go get all pedo because we might not be able to return.
You might not.
I know, man.
Even though I'm legal, man, they look at my last name and be like, you don't belong back.
Damn.
What's your last name, bro? Deportate?
It's Miramontes.
Ali.
Oh, there.
Oh, yeah, bro. That sounds like an American dream right there. Miramontes.
Miramontes.
It sounds like a map, bro.
Can't see it from my house.
Yeah.
They'll probably look at it and go, listen, motherfucker, how come you have two last names, Mira and Monte?
Your last name is Montes.
Because we're from the mountains. We're farm people. We're mountain people.
There you go. When's the last time you've been to Mexico, Raul?
I go every 3 to 4 months. I go visit some family.
So you haven't been there for sounds 3 or 4 months?
Sounds fishy. Right? Sounds like you got a wife over there, bro.
Got some cheap
just don't tell my wife over here, eh?
We will tell her, dog.
Hey, man, we're really excited to come see y'all in Albuquerque.
I'm excited, too, bro. I'm going there with Rodrigo and Larry Bubbles Brown. Man.
I know. We already got our VIP tickets and everything.
Hell yeah, bro. Rodrigo wants to know if there are any massage parlors over there.
It's full.
We have all flavors. You can have a Native American. You can have Japanese. You can have Chinese.
God damn, it's like those massage parlors in Macau.
You know what's funny, bro? You say Native American. The only time I ever heard someone order a Native American chick was in that movie 48 Hours. When they're calling up hookers. Yeah. And also get me a Native American for my Indian friend. And then when they show up to kill them, she's wearing like a little, like she's just like Pocahontas.
A little feather?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, oh, dude. Man. This fool.
So what's the vibe
anyways,
over there?
Have a good day, man. Can't wait to see you, Felipe.
Thank you, bro. Thanks for calling in, bro.
Why so fast, dog?
Albuquerque in the house.
All right, listen. We'll see you.
Take us to the Breaking Bad tour, bro.
Fuck yeah, dog.
Oh, that shit is over.
He's gone, huh?
Yeah, they were Breaking Bad tour, bro. That's all they have. We had a guy that called 80 times, bro.
Where's he at now, dog?
I don't know, bro. He gave up, bro. He ordered a pizza instead.
For burn the lines, dog.
What's up, fool?
What's up, fool? What's going on, Felipe?
Chilling, big dog.
Hey, what's up,
who's
man?
This, fool?
This is Eric from Fullerton. It's for real.
What I listen?
What I live?
714 in the house.
What's going on, guys?
Chilling, big dog.
Stay off the lawn, bro.
Hey, what's up?
I got a quick question for you guys. What are you guys doing up for Lent?
Bullshit.
Flaco right here Catholic. Is not Catholic, bro. He can't give up anything, bro.
Oh, shit. He just gave up his weight already.
He gave up his dog, bro.
I gave up enough, bro.
That's the saddest story I ever heard. The family dog kicked out of the fucking family.
I know, man.
Fool. Hey, man. Could you get a dog house outside? Put him in the car already.
The blankets were fighting over for him. That's why. You know what I mean?
If I only had a cat for like less than a year. Fuck, that fool died. I was devastated. These fools give up the dog that was around for 20 years. What the fuck?
It was either dog food or weed, bro. Get the fuck out of here.
Should have gave him to me. No, I'm fucking with you.
That's crazy. Dude.
He showed up to the house. He showed up to the house. Fuck, I had to go take my balls away too.
I know. I forgot about that. At least get him some sunglasses for the tears.
For real, dude.
No wonder he was violent.
Tear dropping eye, you know what I mean?
Should have bit you, dog.
He probably got mad, bro. Fuck, I'm wearing a sweater now.
It was fucked up. He had to move to Sacramento.
So what's up, bro? Do people in Fullerton feel safer now or more scared than they did 4 years ago?
Or 2 days ago. But...
I mean, they should be all right. I mean, I've only been living there for a couple of years, but I've been living in L.A. pretty much all my life, so...
Orale.
You know what I mean?
Orale,
but I was trying to call in last month for the call in, but I couldn't get through. But
you're here.
I just want to tell you guys, Felipe. I was at the Noble show on the 10 o'clock show, the late show, and that thing was hilarious. And then I rolled deep. Like I told my girlfriend, we rolled like 9 deep in there. So it was pretty cool. And they had a really good time. So,
fuck yeah.
You know, they loved it. You know what I mean? So,
hell yeah.
Really cool.
You were at that show with a guy who married 9 years, huh?
No, yeah, the one who's like, hey, bro, no pressure, bro, just ask me now. I was like,
that fool got red, dog, and his girlfriend kept staring at him, bro, and he couldn't look at her, and he couldn't look at me no more.
The funny thing is, like, I think Rodrigo or you posted the following day of, like, the Instagram
the guy
video of this guy getting slapped by his girl or something or whatever. That was pretty
hilarious. The guy asked her to marry her and she passed out. Remember she fell back?
Wow. Oh my god.
No, that was pretty hilarious though. But yeah, I mean, you know, I just can't wait for your special, you know. I mean congratulations on getting picked up by HBO, so it's a big deal, you know what I mean?
Hell yeah, man. I'm all happy.
So, you know.
Yeah. Thank you, man, for listening.
It just sucks. I gotta wait until like September or whatnot, but you know, should be good. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man. We'll try to hold you over on a podcast till September.
There you go.
That way, bro. Flacco here, bro. Flacco, give him a joke.
Oh, man. One of my jokes.
Give him a Facebook joke.
Give him a Facebook joke.
Hey, man. Those kids wouldn't be on that lawn if Disneyland wasn't so fucking expensive. I don't know. I don't know.
We're going to pull out a gun and shoot him right now.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'm not
man.
Good off the fly.
Sorry. Right to bear arms, eh?
I'm going to be in Irvine in May, bro.
All right. That sounds good.
At the Irvine Improv.
Be all over the country.
Hell yeah.
So it should be cool. But, no, I appreciate what you guys are doing. You know, you guys keep the funny up and, you know, take care, guys. You know what I mean?
Hell yeah, bro. Do you play Madden?
You know what? I don't. I mean, I'm a big gamer, but like, I just watch a lot of basketball. But I know you're into that Madden because I remember that story where you like met some millionaire and he like taught you how to play and get like all these draft picks and stuff. That was pretty cool.
Yeah, man. I didn't even know that guy, man. He gave me all his good players. I'm gonna do you a favor. I'm gonna do you a solid. That's what he said. We're on the phone. I have my pick. Hey, you there? You there? I said, yeah, I'm here. Yep. Hey, man. I'm gonna give you some of my players, man. And he gave me a good player, Marshall Lidge.
What was this? What was the scores?
Oh, bro, he beat the shit out of me, dude. it was 66-2 or 3.
He beat the shit out of me with good players, eh?
Yeah, because you said your rating went up like 10 or 12 points. So you're like,
yeah, hell yeah, bro. I went from 68 to 89.
Like, damn.
Fuck. Money balling.
That's pretty dope, though. You know what I mean? Do you still play or what?
I still play, man, but I switched over to Madden 17.
All right.
I'm at Felipe's. Cool. It's called Felipe's World. You know what's funny, man? On the new Madden, you could be any team. I was playing a guy who was wearing all, like a Mexican NFL football team. He was Los Aguilas.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, you could be any team from any sport?
No, he was just, he had his whole football uniform with Mexican colors. And he had the La Aguila temple, whatever, the Mayan temple on his helmet.
What the shit? I gotta say that.
Tenochtitlan, bro.
Yeah, man. We're being ready.
Damn. You need some Lucha Libre mask right there. You know what I mean? That's all you have to
do. Yeah, I left by 9 goals. All right. But thanks for calling, bro. All the way from Fullerton.
Right, Phil.
Appreciate it, man. All right. Stay shiny, Rodrigo. Take care. Man. What's up, fool?
What's up, fool? Give me what's up.
What's up, fool?
What's up, fool? We got Flacco here.
What's up, guys?
What's up? Is he dead yet?
Oh, this fucker, eh?
All right, wise guy, who is this?
Yeah, who's this? What are you calling
Hey,
from?
Wise guy.
Victor from Eagle Rock.
Oh, always, dude. What's up, fool? Sorry, I haven't called
you
back.
Shout out to Organics in Eagle Rock.
What's up, Victor?
Not much, man. Just chilling before work.
I think Rodrigo, man, lets this guy kick it through all the time.
Oh, I have nothing to do with the phone lines,
I think
dude.
This guy and that lady rob people, bro. Hey, bro, so what happened to that lady that robbed Rodrigo?
What's up with that bitch?
Oh, she came out my house yesterday looking for somebody, and I was like, wrong house, keep it moving.
Shit, you're a dick to that lady, huh, fool?
Me?
Yeah.
What's the story behind that?
Dude, that was the Rodrigo landlord stole $1,700 from him.
What? 14.
14.
Damn, every time he keeps adding more money, it started off with 800.
Call him next month.
I'm calling Robert Shapiro, dude. We're going to handle this, dog.
Yeah, man.
Do a deal.
Next time you call, bro, we're going to say she stole a box of Yeah Man shirts.
For sure. Let's call him Josh Shapiro. The most college.
It's full, dog.
It's all good. I'm calling
you
to say what's up.
What's up, homie? You're the homie, dog.
Hell yeah, the Eagle Rock homie.
All right, what's guys. Up, I'm calling in. Let somebody else get in because I get in every month. It's not fair.
Wait, but do you feel safer?
Yeah, in America now, fool?
In America.
I feel safer? No, man, I feel safe. $15 for Egg Benedict and Highland Park. It's outrageous, you know?
Fuck.
God damn, yeah. Dog.
That means that at the airport, that would have been $30.
There you go. No more hipster that's spots for you, dog.
Oh, man, you got to stop eating at classy places, bro. Go back to Tom's. go eat at that fucking, the Five Burger Family Special on York.
Fucking El Huarache Azteca,
right there. No, right there at Penny's.
Pennies, yes.
Pennies, dog.
Hey, if either Pennies or Troy Burgers, bro.
Troy's, right?
Troy's ain't bad either, dog.
La Estrella.
I went through a Chivago, bro, to Troy's. Oh, man.
Troy's is good, dog. I haven't been there in eons, bro.
Yeah. Rick's Burgers, bro. Best breakfast burrito, bro. Those fucking potatoes taste stale, but they're still good.
The one in East LA is really good, yeah.
Lucky Boy in Pasadena for breakfast burritos is good, too.
Oh, there you go.
They have a Lucky Boy in downtown LA, and at downtown LA, right, to go there.
I don't want
to
say anything, but we exterminate that place.
I don't want to say anything, but I'm going to say
Rodrigo,
this.
What's up, dog? You should make an app for restaurants that get exterminated so people avoid them.
We should work on that, and we're going to be partners, fool. Startup.
Call up Jacob, bro, from Seattle.
It's all good.
Hell yeah, dude. Guys. All right, fool. Keep shining, dog.
I think the restaurant if you do that, the restaurant will sue you, bro.
What's that?
Or you'll lose business from you guys.
What's up, fool?
You'd be surprised.
Who are we talking to? Where are you from?
Hey, bro, lower your radio, bro. You have two phones on.
What's up?
Orale, we'll see you.
What's up, fool?
So he's talking to himself, dog.
A bunch of friends and family are going to go check out the show, man.
This is your brain on drugs.
All right,
you're going to have to call back, dude.
No, but see you in El Paso, bro.
People get pest control for preventative measures, so they don't get those plagas.
Hello.
Hola.
¿Qué tal? Buenos días.
Where's Flaco at?
Flaco's right here, bro.
Waiting for you,
bro. Who's this? Where are you calling from?
Flaco, this is Rico and Mambo. You need to pick us up, bro.
Oh, Rico was that today? Mambo. Was that today? Oh, shit. My bad, bro.
I don't have a bell.
Yeah, fool. Next time, let me know, dog. I'll step in, fool.
You're the only Uber driver that gets high, bro, when you're driving.
I'm probably not the only one. I'm one amongst many, but yeah. What's up, guys? Where you at? Ventura? Oh, you're
what happened, bro? You supposed to pick them up, fool, or what?
We're waiting for you, fool.
I'll be there right now, bro, as soon as I'm done. Just wait for me.
Yeah, it said it's never been the same since you guys fired that white girl.
No, I love Kat.
She got too old on us, bro.
Shout out to Kat. What's up?
She got mad, bro, and you guys told her she wasn't Native American.
He's a Comanche from the Slapaho tribe, man.
Rico and Mambo, fool, shout out.
Oxnard's finest.
Fuck, hey, I'm honored, bro. Another DJ's calling a podcast.
Yeah, I know, right? You guys have a cool podcast in the morning. Eh?
Flaco's right here, bro. That fool looks healthy, bro.
Yeah, man.
You guys need to come back to Oxnard, bro.
We're down, bro.
Coming back in August, bro.
Can't wait, dog.
August, fucking Flaco will be dead by then, bro.
This fool, dog.
Nah, bro, we're going to freeze him, bro.
Jesus Christ.
You're going to be like Carbone in Goodfellas.
We're going to put that fool in one of those freezers like fucking Han Solo, bro.
Oh, shit. Yeah, let's Vanilla Sky this shit, all right?
He's going to go to rehab, bro, with Willie Barcena.
Oh, this guy. I would never go to rehab.
Take you under my wing, bro.
What's
up, Rico and Mambo?
Hey, Rico and Mambo, you guys feel safer in America?
Not when you're driving, bro.
In America?
Yeah.
Fuck no, dog.
The fool of losing listeners every day, bro.
You're gonna change the fucking chapas on us, eh? My keys don't work.
Why would you feel safer? Fuck that.
Hell no, man. Now when Rico and Mambo call people, they think of the immigration calling, bro.
All right, locals. You guys have a good one, man.
All right, guys.
Shout out to Rico and Mambo, bro.
Shout out to
yeah,
Rico.
Man.
Thanks for calling, guys.
We're honored.
Hell yeah, dude.
I'm not worthy. My nipples are hard, bro. I feel honored here.
I know, right? Those guys are cool, man.
We got radio guys calling us.
Hello.
What's up, fool?
What's up, fool?
Who's this?
Mr. Wessel, calling from Fort Worth. What's up?
What's up, Mr. Wessel, all the way from Fort Worth, Texas?
What's up, big dog? Thank you for those stickers, homie.
Hey, you like those stickers, man?
I still got them on my backpack. On my backpack. Not my backpack, on my merch bag.
Yeah.
Oh,
and
nice,
our notebooks
nice,
and stuff.
Nice.
Wait, who's Mr. Wessel? Is he skinnier than me?
No.
Is it like an
thick,
ironic thing?
He has thick Wessels.
Oh, okay. It's like an ironic thing.
He's normal, dog.
Me?
Yeah. No, you got Flacco here because they call you Wessel. He thinks you're skinny. I mean, so, no, man, he's big bone.
I'm about as fat as you could get, man, called Wessel, but yeah. It's all good, man.
They call him Wessel because when he eats meat, he leaves all the Wessel.
All the Wessel.
Bone dry.
No, yeah, it's all good. Now, man, just here with my wife. We're cooking for the church today. We got a lot of people going to eat.
Amen.
But, yeah, man. So, yeah, I figured I'd try and call you guys. I never called in before, so I'll be the first time for everything, right?
Right on.
Yep.
Yeah. So what's up with you guys?
What's up? We're just asking people, man, do you feel safer in America? Because everybody's talking about we should be afraid of everything, about criminals, terrorism, immigrants. Yeah. But do you feel safe?
Sure, I always feel safe, man. We get to carry here in Texas, so you know I always feel safe.
That's what I'm talking about.
But I don't know if you guys noticed or not, I have some Arabic tattoos on my arm. So I don't know if I always feel safe, but I do feel safe. You know what I mean?
Damn, you let the genie out of the bottle.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, man. No, but I feel safe.
What does your arm say in Arabic? Pay buy more gas?
No, on the top of my hand it says Allah Mahatma. It means God of love. Because that's it separates me from I was gonna convert to Islam a long time. It's a long story. I was gonna convert to Islam a long time ago and
what I'm talking
I decided
about, brother.
Not to, so I got some other stuff that says on there that only certain people can read and never know what it says. Yeah. That's about it, though.
That's funny you say that because I never thought about converting to Islam, but there used to be a tattoo that I used to like. It wasn't a tattoo, but it was like a Muslim art, and it was a big-ass tiger, bro. And it was painted good, and it was like kind of
the meaning behind
thick. It means like strength and all that. And I was thinking about putting it on my back, and then 9/11 happened. And I said, hell no, what if I get locked up?
So what if I get locked up?
He said, no.
I get locked up, the way I look, and these guys feel like all of a sudden they're patriots when they're locked up.
Yeah, you never know. Right?
That's true. That's very true.
Yeah, but I still probably get it one day,
get it,
bro.
Dog.
But I want the pain, dog.
I can't.
Take an edible, fool.
Flacco, you think about getting tattoos? It'll probably kill you, huh?
Dude. I can't find someone that could draw on me, bro.
I don't have tattoos, but I have skin disease, dog.
Oh, man.
What time? Flacco had a hickey one time and lasted a year, huh? To come up.
A whole year?
<Let's> go.
No.
He had a big-ass cookie spoon to get it off.
No, man. You're messing,
a big old frozen spoon, yeah.
It has a disease from the blood.
Hey, bro, we're looking for we're asking also our listeners. We Lisa, the manager, she asked it maybe like 4 months ago. We're looking for a new design for the What's Up Food podcast logo. And since you do graffiti, bro, maybe you would like to submit some stuff. And if we like it, we'll give you a credit, or Lisa might give you some cash. We'll pay for it.
Well, how about some of that enchilada casserole? How about some? She should pay me in that. Enchilada casserole.
You want an enchilada casserole logo? Oh, we already have one, though.
No, I want a plate of enchilada casserole.
Oh,
a plate?
If you can make one.
Yeah, bro, we'll make you a plate. We'll freeze it and send it to you. Vegan one, though.
A tray?
A vegan one? You said a vegan one?
Yeah.
You know, I was, about 3 years ago, I was vegan for about a year.
What happened?
And I didn't lose any weight. I did it for my stomach. I didn't lose any weight. I was hungry all the time. I was eating salad. I was eating everything. So I started eating steak again. So, yeah, I was sick for like the first week, but I started eating meat again.
You know, the first time I tried, when I was cleaning up, you know, not eating meat, I went to a bathroom, and I swear to God, I shit black, like black tar. And it came out like a piece of liver. And I was wondering what that shit was.
That's probably what was stuck right there.
I couldn't believe
you
it,
pain,
bro.
Fool.
And then I went to look it up, and it said that's normal when my body was cleaning itself, bro.
Because you You did. Yep. You went vegetarian first, right?
Yeah, bro. It was sludge, bro.
Just out.
So imagine how much sludge we build up over our lifetime.
Yep. Yeah. That's how it was.
I know what you mean,
bro. But did you go eat at vegan restaurants like Spiral Diner in Fort Worth?
Yeah.
Oh, you like that stuff?
That place
huh?
is bomb, man. That's just a bomb hell, dog.
I've been there. Yeah, I've been there before. Like I said, when we were vegan, like my wife was cook, she would cook and stuff, and we go other places. But I did. I spent like three months that I was on the road doing a lot of work, and that's hard being vegan when you travel. So I give you a lot of respect for what you do because it's not easy when you travel, man,
it's difficult,
and try
dude.
To stick to that. You know, it's hard,
but
man.
But not impossible.
So, yeah.
That's what's up.
Thank you, man. Thank you for calling, bro.
Hell yeah. Thank you for those gifts, man. Those stickers, man. That was fucking hella cool, dude.
Yeah, no problem. I'll catch up with you guys again one of these days. I'll come out there and see you guys one of these days. But you guys be good, man.
Hell yeah. Have a good day feeding those people, man. Keep shining.
All right, Wessel. Have a good one, bro.
Yeah, you too, man. I'll talk to you guys later.
Hell yeah.
Later. I wonder what the hell he ate.
Hey, who is this? Who are we going with? Where are you at?
What's up, fool?
What's up, fool?
Hello.
What's up?
Who's this?
Who's this?
It's Rick, man.
Rick, from where, Rick?
Rick, bro, from house arrest.
From house arrest?
Nah. I'm clean. I'm from Florida.
Oh, from Florida. Oh. Is it Rick? Are you the guy that went to our show in Fort Myers?
No, man, that's Choriz, man. You're always confusing me, man.
Yeah, that's Choriz. I was going to say, that's Choriz, dog. The fisherman.
The fisherman. This is Rick, the other guy.
How you been living, dog? What the fuck is cracking out there? How do you feel? Do you feel safe in America now?
I always been safe, man.
That's what I'm talking about, dog.
They carry guns in Florida, too.
Open carry. Who goes there?
Yeah, I don't fuck with them, though.
Just like that man sending them in.
So what's up, fool? You got a question for Flacco?
What up, Rick? Flacco was there today, right?
He's right here.
Yeah,
bro.
Right here, man. What's going on?
Right before you.
What's up, Flacco?
Yeah, what's up, Rick? What's up?
What's up, man? When are you going to visit the emergency rooms here in Florida?
So I'm gonna start that emergency room tour there pretty soon, bro.
All right.
You should go to Texas, bro. The hospice place.
I heard the doses are strong in Texas. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'll be soon, bro. I'll be soon, though. But thank you, man.
The snoozer over here, dog.
Your shit, right? Everyone knows that. Fuck.
They know everything, bro.
The pressure point.
Squeeze my neck, you're a dick.
What's up, Ricky?
Not mad. Just getting ready for your show in Tampa.
We'll be there, bro.
How's the weather out there right now, dog?
Oh, hot in the motherfucker, man.
Oh, heat it, man. Humid, huh?
Humid. Like a motherfucker.
Even in March.
Wow. Could I wear an air-conditioned costume, dog?
I like Tampa, bro. Man. They have Tampa. They have wild chickens running around.
They
That's
do, dog.
Ebor, though, man.
Yeah.
Ebor, you're right.
Right there, right there in Ebor, dude. They creep on the streets. Yeah. Lizards and shit.
They walk around like they're part of the neighborhood. Nobody even does them nothing. Not even dogs bite them.
Nah, fool.
Dogs know better.
Wow. Yeah. I guess they like that old shit there, right? But yeah, man. I'm getting ready for your show, man. Hopefully, you know, I get to enjoy everything else that's going on there, too. You know, you got all the black comics there, too. I've never seen them. So.
Yeah, you're going to love those guys, bro. They're real professional and hilarious.
Yeah, it's something to look forward to, man.
Yeah,
so
man,
you're
going to love
and,
Bruce
you going to have your merch there or not?
I won't have no merch, but the Bruce will have merch.
That's all right, man. I can't wear the Big Daddy shirt.
They're our big shirts.
Yeah, we'll be right there with Big Ski at the merch booth.
Yeah, we'll be right there.
Yeah. All right, that sounds good.
Looking Rick, dog.
Well, thanks for calling, Rick.
Thanks, Rick.
Yeah, this is something out, man. Extra,
all right,
extra,
guys. Extra
large.
All right,
fool.
See you in Tampa, all right, baby. Man. All right.
Only Bruce sells merch.
He's the only one.
Mike Epton. I wonder what's going to happen because Mike was arrested.
Man, I got 30 minutes of new material, Felipe.
Shit, Mike.
A lot of punchlines in that motherfucker.
Oh, man, TC ripped his sweats.
Get him a new
They dusted his hat off.
I want to see the footage, though.
What's up, fool?
What's up, fool?
Who's this, dog?
This is Ozzy Garcia from Corpus Christi, Texas.
Ozzy Garcia.
Ozzy, all the way from Corpitos in the house. Hey, bro, I heard you made a music video, bro, about Corpus Christi a long time ago.
Nah, that's not me. Hey, that might have been Michael White.
Those food were whack, huh?
They opened up for the Kumba Kings once, you know?
Oh, shit, that's Nino. Yeah,
the little outfits and shit.
You know Nino, bro?
I just know him through John Roman.
Oh, shit.
Oh, we don't say bad words on this show.
John Roman, wow.
Dilbert.
I think the last time we talked about him, we were talking about how he got fired from the riding that train at the mall.
His job got derailed.
I heard you talking about that on the last podcast.
Yeah.
Yeah, he runs a comedy club now called Comics 5. He was running Mesquite Street Pizzeria, downtown Corpus Christi. So now he's working at the restaurant. But yeah, no, he was. I know he was doing the
Gators. The last time I worked with him, at Gators in Corpus Christi.
John Roman.
I remember Gators, yeah. Holy shit. He's been booking you for a long time in Corpus, huh?
Yeah.
Or he used
to. Now I get booked at Mesquite now with the other guy. I think Javi Luna works with a guy.
Javi Luna, yeah, and Brandon.
Yeah,
I met
Brandon.
I got to take a picture with you. It was me and my brother. We look alike. It was the last time you were here in Corpus. It was, dude, that's when I first seen you live. It's hilarious.
Thank
my
you, man. Like, dude, was it a Mesquite or Gators?
Mesquite.
Oh, the Mesquite.
Mesquite Street.
Yeah, that was fun gig. Were you there, fool?
Yeah, fool. And then we did that open mic on the last night.
Oh, yeah.
Snails there, right?
Oh, you had Escar.
No, that was in McAllen. Oh, my God. That shit was delicious.
So what, bro? Do you feel safer now in America, or you feel the same?
Tell us the truth. Okay.
Or should we send the troops?
The National Guard will be there tomorrow. Okay.
I feel all right, dude. I feel pretty safe. It's kind of, because I lived in New York City, and I went to culinary school there, and I worked there for 5 years. And then I lived in Maine for a year and a half, but since I moved back down to Texas, people are pretty hostile. Not everyone,
cheese, huh?
Of course, but it's just in general. So I don't know. I feel all right, dude.
What kind of hostility are you talking about there, Ozzy?
Yes, sir.
Because before, I think what it is now is like, you know, when you walk around the street and you're like, man, does that Mexican fool have a knife on him? But now it's more like, is that Mexican fool here illegal or not illegal? It's like a game white people play with each other. Who's illegal and who's not illegal? I mean, made that up, but I'm pretty sure that's what I would be playing.
Fox News white people. I don't think reasonable, cool white people. Down-to-earth white people.
Yeah, Fox News 11 white people.
What's up with that girl sitting on the couch, bro? About to get blow everybody in the fucking Oval Office.
That's what I'm talking about.
I thought she kneeled down, bro. Was about to blow everybody, though.
They're pretty
everybody, get in turn, eh?
They're pretty stressed out. I think they need that about right now. Isn't Trump yesterday on his little speech to Congress, we need to stand together. I'm asking every member in Congress. Okay.
That's a pretty good Donald Trump, bro.
I'm working on it. Okay. Thank you. Trying to make these impressions great again. Okay.
Yeah, man. What's up, fool? Thank you for calling, bro. We're from Corpus Christi, bro. You know, when we were the last time I was there, some fucking white lady, she ordered a pickle juice snow cone.
Oh, what the
fuck? And is that a Texas thing? Because they were in San Antonio too, fool.
Is that a Texas thing, bro? Pickle juice flavor.
Yeah. What?
Do Mexicans order that shit too?
That Mexican lady was gonna order, remember? Oh, it's good. I was like, ugh. Patas, eh?
Patas. Okay, it's a poor hillbilly Latino thing.
Yeah.
They drank pickle juice as kids.
Really? Is that what they drink with Jameson?
Flaco likes pig feet juice, raspados.
Oh, get out of here.
I could just imagine the little skin on it, dude. On the nasty. Ice.
Yeah.
Hey, Felipe.
Yes.
One question. Dude, when you come back down the course this summer, because I saw that it's been booked, I'd love to cook something for you, man, and bring it over to Mesquite Street, bro. So a vegan dish for you. Maybe like a veggie burger or something.
I'm ready, bro. Hell yeah.
Just make sure it's fresh, okay?
Yeah, man.
I'll just taste it.
I am down, man.
Hey, real quick, Ozzy, what hostility are you talking about that you feel or see in Corpus right now?
Dude, just the whole, like, you know, just how you doing? You know, just general. I guess it's silly, man. It's kind of hard to explain. I mean, maybe it lies in the sin. You know, I kind of hate when
if I'm in a kind of hostile mood, you know, then when I walk around, I start to presume that other people might be hostile. And then you just kind of start thinking negatively. I think it just has to do on how an individual feels that day. Maybe it's just something I'm going through.
You're a prisoner in your own mind, okay? I'm fucking with you. Keep shining, though.
All right, bro. Turn the TV off today, bro, and don't argue with no one on the internet.
That's what people need to do, dog.
That's why our shows have been sold out this year.
Yeah, dude. Yeah.
All our shows. People want to laugh now.
That, but also, too, I think fucking the Superstore and all that shit has been helping,
maybe?
Too. Yeah, fool. A lot of people see you on that shit, dog.
Yeah, my sister told me she saw you.
Yeah, everybody saw. I see Felipe on Superstore. All right. Christmas episode.
Thank you for calling, bro.
Yeah, I was trying to catch you in San Antonio, but that was sold out.
Yeah, man.
Don't be pissing on the Alamo, dog.
Yeah, bro. I'd love to come go hang out and bring some vegan food, bro. Hit up Rodrigo.
Man. Yeah, man. Hit me up to Twitter, Instagram, any of that stuff.
Hell yeah, bro.
Where is he from?
Corpus.
We don't have a day yet, but it might be late July.
It might be late July.
You heard it from the manager himself.
Yeah, so
you
can make some vegan brisket, bro. Some vegan guisado.
Oh, that'll be good.
Vegan brisket. Oh, shit. I gotta
working
Google
on it.
That.
You got a couple months, okay?
There you go.
Don't mess this
it's
up.
It's all about the flavor.
Yeah, man.
Well, thanks for calling, bro.
Yeah, absolutely, man.
Thanks
for hollering. Appreciate it.
Hell yeah.
About what we were talking about. Hey, you know Ricky Terrace?
Oh, I forgot to ask him. That's the next guy, bro. Let's talk to him like he just hang up. Okay, man.
Talking to Mondo yesterday.
I forgot to tell you that shit, man. What's up, fool? Thanks for calling. Talk to you later. Bye. Hello?
Yo, what's up, fool?
What's up,
fool? Hey, bro, you ever heard of a comedian named Rick Gutierrez?
Nah, man. Never heard of that, dude.
Yeah, man.
Why,
yeah,
you
man.
Owe you money or
what's
what?
What's going on, man?
Neither have we, man. Anyways, who's this?
Hey, man, this is Angel Iturbe, man. How's it going?
Un angelito, bro.
What's up, man? Where you calling from, Angel?
You sound like somebody that followed
What's up,
Instagram.
Flaco?
What's up,
they
bro?
They got an urgent care clinic there,
Jesus
close,
Christ, bro. We have a nurse down the street, bro. Where are you calling from, Angel?
The ER, dog. I see you, homie.
Hell yeah. Dude. What's up, man? You guys were just in San Antonio, man. I heard it was a good show.
Yes, man. Other shows were sold out, bro.
Crazy,
I hate the Tex-Mex food, though, bro. I can't fucking stand that shit.
You and me both.
You're not alone, bro.
All Mex. It needs to be all Mex, dude.
Man,
Tex.
That's funny you say that because the guy that we mentioned right now, that dude,
yeah.
One time we were in a car, and that fool said that brisket is better than carne asada, and Gabriel Iglesias almost kicked him out of the car. Even our engineer agrees,
like,
bro.
That's our version of the Uncle Tom, dude, the Uncle Tomas, dude. You fucking Trump voter, dude.
You're right about
fucking
that.
Fucking Latino for Trump. I don't know this fool, but I'm just guessing, you know?
Yeah, man.
But yeah, man. What's up? How you guys doing, man?
Good, we're doing good, bro. Right here, man. We brought Flaco back to life right here. He has a show in San Jose.
San Jose. Where you calling from, Angel?
Pobrecito. Just get him an emergency, man. He'll be all right. He'll make this it through the rest of the
Try
show.
Try to get him some wings, okay?
Okay. God. Hey, don't scare me with that fucking voice, man. Fucking both. Hey, man, midterm elections, man.
They're scaring you?
We got to hobble the orange one, man. Voting some fuckers out.
We got it, bro.
There you go. You feel safer since?
Do you feel safer since Trump been president?
Hey, man, I grew up in El Paso, L.A. and El Paso, and
wow, it sounded like you were punished twice.
Fuck, man. Hey, man, I heard that shit, man. Hey, shout out to my family in Cudahy, man. I got
shit, Cudahy!
Bonita Park.
What?
Yeah, fucking HB. Linwood, man.
Oh, bro.
I lived in Linwood in the 80s, man.
Yeah, hell yeah, bro. I used to go eat in Huntington Park. It's funny, my father never took it to McDonald's. He never took it to eat anywhere, but he would take it to Huntington Park right there on Pacific and I think Soto Street where Vernon and HP meet, some place called Andy's Super Burgers.
Oh.
Hell yeah, man. Hell yeah. Hey, I used to live in Linwood. Close to Southgate, man, close to Imperial Highway.
Southgate.
Hey, man, I don't expect you to know where that's at, man.
The birthplace
of
Cypress
Hill. Isn't Southgate from Slayer? Isn't Slayer from Southgate?
Hell yeah. Maywood, actually, but Southgate area. One of the guys is from there.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, dog. Fuck yeah, dude.
Yeah, man.
Breeding a lot of good music
there. Well, you guys, man, keep on being shiny, dude.
Okay, bro. Thanks for calling.
We'll do that exactly. Okay.
Okay. All right, man. Take care.
Thanks for calling, bro.
Thank you, Angel.
Angel Iturbi.
Iturbi.
Say hello to this guy.
Hey, I'm sorry. Who's the next caller? How's it going? Where are you calling from? Calling from?
What's up, fool? That was Flacco over there, bro. Trying to finish a sentence over there.
Put him on the respirator again, dog. Give him some oxygen.
If you guys want to see Flacco, exactly. Man, he plays one of the characters in that show Taboo. He's the guy laying down on the floor, bro.
I thought it was
with a crow on top of his head. What's up, bro? We have a question. We've been asking everybody, do you feel safer in America now that Trump is president, or you feel the same and nothing's changed?
Man, I have no idea. Honestly, same thing. Really?
That's what everybody's saying, man. I think fear is just in your imagination.
Hell yeah. All that shit you're watching on TV, all the shit you're reading.
If you think about it, man, if you compare 2017 to 1890, hell yeah, I feel safer.
Oh, dude. Go fucking cut your throat.
Because if you go back to 80 history and time, it wasn't that good for us, bro.
It's always been a battle of the resources.
But hell yeah, I feel safer, bro, because none of my family being hung, no one's taking our land.
Dude, back then they didn't give a shit about you, dude. Now if you're like homeless or if you're whatever you are and they kill you, they will do an investigation. Back then they'll just throw your ass in a river and fucking keep moving.
Yeah, Mexicans just got hung too.
Yeah, they put
I don't watch the news, so you know what I mean. I don't really see you know what. And when I do catch something about Trump president, I mean, it feels like a dream. It feels like what the fuck.
Like it's still not real.
At least it's a dream and not a nightmare.
Show.
Okay.
It's like a game show.
Bingo, you won.
Yeah, it's like it feels like his presidency feels more like a real bad reality show, and we're all tuning in.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's like a bad SNL sketch.
It's like Lisa, the manager, has to wake up every morning and see what Trump tweeted.
Oh man! I mean, if I paid attention, honestly, I'll go crazy. That's why I have to leave it alone.
Imagine how many people are going crazy.
Oh yeah, they are, and it's like the other side going crazy when OB was in the office. You know what I mean?
Yeah. That was. He actually had some type of history. You know what I mean? They were mad for the wrong reason, but it's like he had a history in actual politics. But this guy is like, it's crazy, man. Like you said, it's a crazy reality TV show.
Yeah, but just look at the people he hired.
I wish I could fall asleep for like 4 years and then just wake up and just see what happens. You know what I mean?
Get high, dog.
Get high.
We're gonna freeze Flacco for 2 days, though. So. That's crazy.
Not happening. For you guys.
Hell yeah, bro.
You ready?
Yeah, man.
Okay. How many times did Emilio say, you know what I'm saying?
I don't know, Holmes. How many times did he say that?
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You dig what I'm saying?
Hey, you dig, Holmes?
How many times?
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? How many times?
I don't know.
0 to 50 through the whole podcast. 0 to 50, 50 to 100, 150 or more than 150.
That's not a fair question,
50.
Holmes. 75.
0 to 50.
0 to 50.
123.
Ooh, okay.
Have you counted?
Hey, Holmes, I know you were saying you want to go to sleep for 4 years. Start right now, Holmes.
I actually counted.
That's chingada with your stupid-ass statistics, Holmes.
75?
183.
183. Wow. When I used to ride BMX, I did 180, Holmes.
183.
You know what
I'm saying? You dig, Holmes?
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly, Holmes. You know what I'm saying, Holmes.
I used to, when I was in rehab, there used to be a preacher, and he was from Pico Rivera. He was from Cantarranas, right?
Orale.
And he was a pastor, and that fool used to say, you know what I mean? So the Lord came to the store and took over the Jesuits, and you know what I mean?
He bought a 40, Holmes.
Hallelujah, you know what I mean?
I had a cholo baseball coach in Little League. He's all, just a little reminder, you guys, throughout the whole fucking day.
Just a little reminder.
Right before the game started, just a little reminder, you guys, you're not going to play today. Just a little reminder.
That fool had one teacher before he dropped out, bro.
Yeah, dude.
Just a little reminder, I'm not going to graduate, eh?
Fuck.
Speaking of, what did the other specials say over and over? You know what I'm saying?
Media?
Oh, man. Lisa saw a special where the comedian kept saying, "You don't understand," over and over.
You don't understand.
But you don't understand, over and over.
But you don't understand.
You know what I say a lot, I catch myself saying, you know what's weird? All the time.
You know what's weird?
But it's probably peculiar. I can let that one slide.
But I don't think everything I say is weird, though. I go over my set, and
you know
I say,
you say, all of a sudden.
All of a sudden?
You know I say, weird?
Who,
water.
That flaco or me?
All of a sudden? I don't say all of a sudden.
Hey, keep it, all of a sudden.
Hey, Holmes, fuck you and your clicker, Holmes. Fuck that dedo, Holmes.
I'm so fucking Latino Chomsky here, bro.
Fucking poster fucking right here, dog.
Chompy right here, bro.
You dig, Holmes, or what?
Hey, how many times does Gabriel say chocolate, bro? It's special.
Hey, how many times did San Juan lisp?
I'm gonna tell you something, okay? I'm gonna tell you something. Look, girls, you guys gotta be powerful, okay? Cut and paste generation, listen to me.
Shout out to
like
San One.
Troll doll, dude.
Well, she draws them. Shout out to San One and Reverie, rapper.
Oh, yeah, please.
I saw a photo of them together, bro.
Really?
I thought they were gonna go at it, bro, but they didn't go at it.
Huh. You know, Reverie doesn't wanna mess up her face.
What's up, fool? Bro, you're hilarious, bro.
Hey, Holmes.
I want you to go over this podcast, the call-in, and tell us how many listeners said something over and over.
You know what I'm saying?
I say weird a lot. You know what's weird, bro? You know what's weird? On stage, too, it kills me.
It might be weird, Holmes, you know? It's just weird you say it.
Or also, when I'm losing the crowd, losing the audience, I always say, like, and fucking this, fucking that.
Let's do that.
We gotta drop some fucking bombs, okay?
I'm gonna come up with some more games, but yeah, I tried to do the San Juan lisp, and I started losing my mind after like 7 minutes.
I would lose my mind too, okay?
That's a good one, bro. You'll be a regular caller from now on.
Statistic George over here.
What's your name again?
Alex DeLarge.
Oh, what's up, fool?
Hey, why are you disguising yourself and not mentioning DeLarge in the beginning,
yeah,
bro?
Yeah, bro. Why everybody big trying to be cute?
You're fucking talking to fucking strangers, by the way.
Alex at large.
Yeah, Alex DeLarge. Maui and Sons.
We got Flaco the Thin here.
Yeah, Flaco the Thin. Small, yeah. Fucking Slice.
Flaco scared me. That's why I didn't say my name.
Oh, this guy.
DeLarge. But is it really DeLarge?
Oh, dude, you had me dying. You said Flacco's hand looks like a foot without an ankle. Oh, my God.
Old chicken foot.
I know, but when he does push-up, look, he's walking.
All right, man, I'm out of here.
All right, everybody, bro. He's out of here, bro.
All right, don't
you? I haven't called in a while.
Where you from, bro? Where you from?
What city calling from, Alex?
Mid-City, West L.A.
Bro, you are the fucking count of Mid-City, bro. Later, dog.
All right, clicker. I love you.
Shout out to the count.
All right,
the count of
one
Mid-City.
One list, two list, two, three, four.
You know right, what I'm saying.
All right, man.
Yeah, man.
Shout out to producer. Love you guys.
Shout out. She's right here, bro.
Hell yeah, man.
How many times are you going to say yeah, man, bro? And fucking...
Oh, there it is. That's a good one.
I don't really say it a lot.
Yeah, man. All right.
They say it for me. Okay.
All right, fool. Thanks for calling Alex Large.
DeLarge. Comedy, dog.
Everybody sounds cute, huh? When they're fat, huh?
I was all hiding, dog.
DeLarge, Wessel.
Yeah, DJ Cooch.
What's up, man?
You fucking wrestling somebody, though?
God damn, fool.
You slashed your phone.
It's a restless-ass fucking phone, there.
What, you calling from Clifton's?
What's cracking?
Who are you talking to? Where are you calling from, bro?
I like the meatloaf there.
I'm calling from San Diego.
San Diego, what?
San Diego.
Chicano Park, homie.
Is this Big Frog? Yeah,
it's Frog or what?
Fucking hotter than a motherfucker out here.
Really? What? San Diego?
Oh, shit. We got to go to San Diego.
It's hot.
Let me ask you a question, Felipe. When are you going to do a show out here at the comedy clubs out here, man?
We don't have a date yet, man. The last time I was there, we were at the Humphreys by the Bay.
All right, and you can't just do like a spontaneous one. You can't just show up and do it.
You can start saying the word spontaneous.
Well, bro, let me rub my two shoes together, bro. Yeah, but what you could do, bro, you could hit up that comedy club in downtown San Diego and just tell him, bro, what's up, fool? How come you don't bring Felipe back? Just to mess with him, even though I'm not going back to that club.
All right, fuck. What's cracking with you, Rodrigo?
Chilling, fool. Over here shining, dog. What happened?
Are we laughing or what, dog?
Are we napping?
All right, fool. Hey, if anything, you should make an album and shit. Just you laughing, fool. I'd buy it.
Oh, yeah, man, we're working on it, eh? No, this is what's up, dude. My homeboy compiled a thing of iPhone recordings. It's going to call the Brown Eyed Devil, but I'm going to release it on like Spotify and Pandora. So that's what's up with that. It's all the little jokes I've been doing for like the last 5 years.
Yeah, bro. Also, we're going to get we're trying to work on a laugh track where we get all the best things ever said on a podcast. A soundboard, and you get pressed in, you hear like, what's up, fool? Or, yeah, man. Or, Flaco sleeping. Yeah, and we're going to record 5 different Rodrigo laughs for you guys to download.
¿Cómo se las curas, güey?
Hell yeah,
bro. You have ringtones, everybody.
Hell yeah, bro. It's going to be 99 cents.
So, yeah, dude, look forward for that, man. We're going to put it out soon.
We'll put it out soon. We have a limited photo of Flaco leaving to the ambulance on a tarmac.
Hey, in Seattle. I heard that was so fucking skinny, fool. He's scared to go out when it's fucking just windy, dog. You know what I mean? He don't even need a passport. That fool just goes outside and bam, takes off.
Bro, that fool's a kite.
Put a string on that beetle, dog.
I can't wear a windbreaker, bro. That
shut the fuck up, nothing but left for that fool.
Oh, thanks, bro.
Hell yeah, bro.
He's a homie, fool.
Thanks for calling, bro. All
right, what's up, fool?
What's up, fool? Do you feel safer in America now, or do you feel the same?
It's been the same. Actually, it's safer, dog, because you said you grew up in Boyle Heights, no?
Yeah.
It was worse back then than it is now, fool, if you think about it.
Boyle Heights,
like,
man.
In the 90s.
Yeah, it was bad, bro.
It's nice there now, right? You got, like, all the bars and...
One more question, Felipe.
Yes.
I grew up in East L.A. for a little bit. I don't know if you're familiar with City View.
Yeah, City View Stoners.
Yeah, my cousin Miguel used to live out there. I don't know if you know that, fool. That fool was Mr. Popular, dog. He used to live out there, Little Miguel. I don't know if you ever knew that, fool.
Little Miguel? He went to Roosevelt?
Yeah, Roosevelt. Fool, Roosevelt High School for a little bit, and then he went to Palm Springs.
Little Miguel. Little Miguelito, he to box?
He never boxed. But he used to live right there. There used to be a game called State Street Locals.
I heard of State Street Locals. Then they became State Street Stoners, and then it became a real gang.
Yeah, I used to live in that area, too.
Yeah, because I used to know this family. They were really dark, bro. Robert Rodriguez, and they had a sister and another brother. They were dark Mexicans, bro. I think he should hang around with those guys.
I'm not familiar with a lot of people who live there, though, but my cousin lived there for, and I lived with that for a little bit. So I thought you knew him and maybe people there. I don't know.
He was like in his 40s, right?
What was that?
He's like 40 years old or something.
Nah, this vato's young, fool. Fucking, he's 27 now.
Never heard of him.
But
I probably know his dad.
that's his real name too, fool. Miguel. He's a senior. He's 55.
Of them. He's not the guy who stole my bike.
All right, fool. Well, I gotta go.
Thank you for calling, bro.
Orale.
We have a photo here of Toby Hicks, bro, getting randomly selected by 5 TSA guys, bro.
No way.
Yeah, they on me.
Oh, man, they were on him, bro.
My pants are falling.
His pants fell off. Oh, what happened was he don't wear a belt, so Toby Hicks' pants sag. So when he goes through the machine, it buzzes because the buckle, the bottom button is too low. It's not up like a normal pants.
So you went off and you stood there for a while?
Yeah.
That's like fucking 10 minutes, huh?
What's up, fool?
What's up, fool? Hello.
Hello.
What's up, fool?
Hello, what's up, fool?
Who is this?
This is Luis from San Diego.
What Luis from San Diego.
What's up, Luis from San Diego?
Man, so I was kidding right now. I was watching your program, then I heard you say about Andy Superburgers. I grew up in Huntington Park.
Yeah.
Equals, man. Those are like the best burgers. I still come and drive the Huntington Park just for those burgers, man.
Hey, was that shit good?
Money?
That shit was good, huh?
Oh, they're still good.
Man, that's the only place where when you buy a chicken dinner, it is good. It comes with a lot of coleslaw, a fucking tool butter buns, bro, and fucking fried chicken, dog. It was my dad was the
old. No, mind you, man.
My
those
fucking
grilled burgers, yeah. The best.
Dude, my dad used to fucking cut the hamburger in half, bro, and make us split it and a soda, bro. I used to get mad.
Too much for you right now.
Yeah, when I heard you say that, I was like, oh, man, not too many people know about that place, man, because it's right on Santa Fe Avenue.
Yeah, my brother used to call that place Ass Burgers. Because it was called ASB Burgers. It was called Andy Super Burger. And my brother was like, let's go to Ass Burgers.
My dad would get pissed off. I'm surprised that your dad didn't know about this one place on Gage Avenue called Ideal Pizza back in the days. It was like a little mom-and-pop pizzeria, man. But the best pizza, man, and not the pescaderia or fish taco place.
Maron.
Wow. I never heard of that place.
When are you coming over to San Diego?
We're working on a date right now because we were just there at the Humphreys by the Bay. We're probably going to get a date probably at the end of the year. We're shooting for it at the end of the year. Hey, bro, getting back to Andy Superburger, bro. Hey, bro, when that hamburger place, when we used to go there, no había nada, huh? There was nothing around, huh?
Nothing. Over there, we used to ride our little mini bikes and skateboards going down that way. There was nothing, man. Like abandoned buildings over there, man. I mean, shoot, man. Sometimes we would go there, we're like, oh, man, do we really have to go for the burger? We're like, yeah.
Industrial.
Yeah. When we were eating there, it was usually a bunch of Latino families and truck drivers.
See? That's what it was, pretty much. Yeah, because I grew up right there off of, right behind the Honey Park High School on 60th.
Mm-hmm. By the water tower?
All three schools right there. See, I went to Miles Avenue, Gage, and then Honey Park High. And then a lot of people don't know that when I was growing up right there, they filmed Grease right there on Honey Park High.
Oh, really? I always thought it was LA City College.
It was parts on that school, but the scene with the bonfire and the dancing part, where they were dancing John Travolta with the Lewis and John,
yeah,
that was a gymnasium. Cabrones wouldn't let us play in the basketball for a long time, and they had to take off our shoes because they redid the whole floor. And they did all the logos. And if you look in the back of the dance sheet, like, you'll notice there's like a gray and orange Spartan in the back. They redid everything right there for us. But we couldn't use nothing, man. They had us playing with their socks.
They didn't even use you guys for extras, huh? Because you guys look younger than them.
Oh, yeah. No. So all the people that were on the bleachers, when they were doing the bonfire and the little football scene, it was us from the community. They just didn't sit there in La Plata and todo eso. It was pretty cool.
How long were you guys there where they were filming? Probably hours, huh?
Oh, see, man. I met the Cacarito, the bad guy. The guy that looks like an anthill bit him on the face. The bad guy.
Which bad guy was in Greece?
Sandwich game was pretty cool.
Oh, you said with the guy from Taxi Driver?
No, not from Taxi. No. The bad guy from Greece with the black bomb that used to throw fire in the back.
Oh, yeah. He had blondish, dirty hair.
That's it, man. One of them, that's nice, man. And then to comentario then, how do we do it? I feel safe, normal.
It's normal, huh, bro? It's like if you're legally here and if you're a good person, it don't even affect you.
Nothing to worry about, huh?
Nothing to worry about.
It's totally wild. Nothing's changed. I mean, it's all hype, homie. They got nothing better to do. They're protesting.
So mad with it.
You could do things peacefully and get things done the correct way, or if they would have really wanted something, if they really would have went out and vote, they could have made a big change.
Oh, yeah, or vote, or try to convince your racist parents to vote the other way.
Change of heart.
I mean, it's one that makes the change, verdad?
Yeah.
And that's what a lot of these kids don't know. that they're complaining and blocking the freeways and progress. You told us, hey, man, you know, we got to go to work. That's what they don't understand. They're blocking the freeways. So what are they? They're proving really nothing. ¿Sabes qué? There's ways of doing things the peaceful way, a toda madre, nice and mellow, and you get things done more. I mean, you form a groups, huevo, sign petitions, and do it the right way.
Oh, hell yeah. Go get yourself a coca.
People would rather protest than boycott. That's the difference. I would rather boycott than protest. If you boycott, you send a message, bro.
An economical boycott, for sure. You hurt them in the dollars.
Yeah. We're all, a lot of us are like, you know, Hispanos, but we're American citizens. We're born here, so we got a power. A lot of people, I learned a lesson when I was crossing the border one time, and one of the border guys was from Texas, those guys that wear the thin-rimmed hats, you know, real cabrones.
What I'm talking about there, a little Mexican.
Yeah, so he asked me, he goes, hey, so what are you? And then back then, pues, I was young, and he might go, nope, I'm a Chicano. And then he looked at me, he goes, oh, so you're a Chicano? And I'm like, yeah, and he goes, but do you know the significance of that? And I go, pues no, pues sabes que, pues I grew up, you know, Chicano. But then he broke it down. He goes, it really means a small American, a Chico Americano. He goes, you consider yourself a small American?
According to him, Chicanos,
I never heard that one name.
Chicanos only exist in America.
Sí, pero esa palabra that word came from that, the Tohuelos came up, that make us like smaller, like Chico Americanos.
Chico and the Man, then the TV show came out.
Yeah, and I told the guy, I don't consider myself a smaller American, ¿verdad? Because I know Spanish, English, and since I live over in San Diego, a little bit of Tagalog, you know, so I'm picking up three languages, so we're more. Yeah. And a lot of people think that we're minorities, but we're not. We're
Chicanote.
Yeah, so like I don't really know more because of the breakdown of what it really means.
According to that cop over there at the border?
I mean, it's one of those things that a lot of guys don't know. They're like, oh, you know, because I grew up in Chicano, and I respect that todavía. But when you look at the significance, pues, he's like, cabrón, you know. No, I'm not smaller, you know. Orale. Yeah, it's canido. It was a rude awakening when I was a kid. But it's like I said, now I go vote and do my part, you know, and when I kind of go volunteer. You know, you can make a change. But, you know, all these people that are complaining, they're like, you know, especially if we got nothing to hide, you know, you got nothing to worry about. You want the streets tranquilo and a toda madre.
A toda madre.
So I remember I used to walk over there to Compton and down that area when I had long hair back in the day. I was a skateboarder back in the day.
It was a Hessian dog.
So I used to walk over there and go get my weed and toda madre came back and never had no problems.
Hey, bro, you should get the weed over there by the Jamaican guy by the fucking Crenshaw indoor swap meet up. He had the best shit back then, huh?
That was good. You nunca tuve problemas. Never had problems. Never.
Not if you're cool.
If you're cool, bro. Cool. If you're cool, you're cool, bro.
That's it. Everybody's being an asshole. Just be cool. Who gives a fuck?
That's okay.
And then go over there off a Tweety to the tiendita, get yourself a coca and a bag of Red Hot Cheetos, eh? That's it.
Thanks for calling, bro. Like, next time we got to hook up and go to Andy's Burger, bro, and have their delicious onion rings.
Hell yeah, this food nothing but positivity with this food, dog.
No.
Best onion rings ever, bro.
If one of you guys open up an Andy's Super Burger in San Diego, you guys will be bank, man. Because there's nothing like that over here.
There's nothing like that, bro. Where else can you get a fucking deep-fried burrito and a hamburger?
Yes.
Call it chimichanga.
Andy Burgers invented chimichangas, bro. Yeah, they got with old burritos and deep fried them.
Pastrami's? Hijo de
su madre. Oh, shit. I'm vegan, bro, but I remember the fucking hamburger with pastrami on top and bacon.
Yeah.
You didn't have a relapse,
I would eat that later. I'll be like, but delicious.
It has sound effects.
God damn, dog.
Holy, bro.
Drink some water.
Thanks for calling, bro.
Fuck yeah. Keep shining, dog.
All right, guys.
Talk to you later, bro.
I love the positivity, bro.
Later on, bro.
And these burgers.
I've eaten there before.
That's it?
Oh, okay.
Oh. Yeah. What's up, fool? Thank you, everyone who called in. Our last caller, man.
Hell yeah.
We give a big shout out to Andy's Super Burger at Huntington Park on Pacific.
Advertisement.
Pacific.
Santa Fe.
Santa Fe.
Shout out to Flaco, bro. Mention your dates again.
San Jose Improv, Wednesday, March 15th, 8 o'clock. And Ontario Improv, March 28th.
To get tickets for your show on March 15th?
15th, yeah.
15th. Do they go to you or they get the guest list on The Improv.
To the San Jose. The San Jose.
Who was on the show? Anybody worth mentioning?
Tanya Estrada, Monique Flores, Luz Pasos, and Hassan King.
Olele, Tanya Estrada from 95.5, Color West.
There you go.
And what's Birdman, the woman?
And Luz Pasos and Monique Flores.
All right, that's one more, right?
Birdman.
Okay.
Birdman. The Bird's going to do a set too, huh? The chirp, chirp. Chirp.
Birdman chirp. Will be there, man, with his black weed.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
Check me out at the Comedy Store March 8th with Jesus Trejo, Boulevard Nights.
You're doing Spanish?
No, I'm doing English show. Yeah, that's not part of his Spanish entourage. The other guy's
That guy speaks scary Spanish, bro. Olele, tú sabes que vamos a tener un show. Whoa.
It's a catchphrase Spanish.
What's up,
catch
fool?
Catch a wave Spanish.
Don't forget, man, March 11th, Tampa, Florida. One night only with Mike Epps.
What's up,
Spokane, yeah? Washington, March 16th through the 18th.
Shout out to the Hill family.
March 23rd, 25th, El Paso, Texas. Detroit, Michigan, March 31st. April 1st, Baltimore, Florida. I'm lying, Baltimore, Maryland. And shout out to Seth Hill from Spokane and Rory Hill's wife,
Rebecca Guzman.
Hang in there one day at a time. Yeah, Reverie, trying to stay sober one day at a time. Flaco, living just one breath at a time.
Take me away.
No. Shout out to Lisa, the manager, producer of the podcast, Aaron over here. Working the wheels of steel.
Yeah, man.
Also, tune in to All Things Comedy for all the podcasts they have. Al, Dean Del Rey, Bill Burr, the Snod Feast, the Crab Feast, with my boy, Ryan Stickler, and the other guy I hung out with at the Montreal Comedy Festival, Jay Larson.
Yeah, man. Check out the Yeah Man podcast.
What's up, fool? Franco, you have a podcast? No, man, he's a coffin. All right.
Keep shining.